Before we begin, this video is not suitable for family viewing.
That's a gen, yeah.
Assalamu alaikum, guys, and welcome to another episode of Smile to Jannah. Dave Chappelle has been in the news for the last week or so, and it's because of his Netflix special called The Closer, in which he's taken a lot of risks with some jokes.
I didn't see a single joke in there, right?
Careful, Dave, they after you. I said, what? One they or many theys?
He's only made a few points that they really take an issue with. Yeah, the first point is, why on earth did he defend J.K. Rowling, the author, when she goes, sex is fact? Yeah, so he uses the term gender, which is used interchangeably. I'll get into all that. And he goes,
gender is a fact. This is a fact. Every human being in this room, every human being on earth, had to pass through the legs of a woman.
And then he talks about DaBaby, yeah, the rapper, not a little, you know what I'm saying? DaBaby was cancelled because he mentioned a few things about the LGBT community that they didn't like. But Dave's thing was very clever. And he goes, back in the days, DaBaby shot and killed a black person. That wasn't enough for his career to come to an end. But when he offended the LGBTQ community, oh no.
In our country, you can shoot and kill a but you better not hurt a gay person's feelings.
Sex and gender. Yeah, what is sex? Now, sex is male or female, and this is determined by your gametes. Sperm, that's the gametes for males, and eggs are the gametes for females. There is no third option. Gender is divided into two. Yeah, you got gender identity, which is masculine or feminine. Then you've got gender expression, which is clothing, hairstyle, and mannerisms. Firstly, both of these, yeah, sex and gender, are biological.
Because gender is, factually, a social construct.
I mean, come on, this is so obvious.
Both sex and gender are now seen as social constructs, which just means that they are not seen as true, but seen as something which is made up by society.
All trans people are lying about what they feel inside and what they actually identify as?
Just because a person feels like something, or there are exceptions to the rule, that doesn't mean that we should reject basic biology. I mean, some people are born with 11 toes. Yeah, and we've never sat down and said, you know, we have to reconceptualize how many toes is seen as normal, mate. But when it comes to intersex, they're like, yo, because they are intersex people, people that may have genitalia of the opposite gender, that doesn't now mean that we suddenly have to change everything. Let's get to the crux of the matter, yeah? So they're saying that males and females are the same.
There are lots of studies that suggest that actually the structure of trans women's brains are very similar to the structure of cis women's brains.
Let's look at 5 brain differences, yeah? A study shows that verbal fluency is better in women and mental rotation is better in men. Yeah, this was in 2006, as you can see on the screen. Another shows that amygdala activation occurs more in men watching sexual content than women. This was in 2012. Also, the third interstitial nucleus of the anterior hypothalamus is larger in men. This was in 2012. Do you know the whole amygdala, the size of it is larger in men than females? And so this was 2018. And another study, men have greater white matter connections while women have greater connections between the two hemispheres. This was in 2013. Now, when it comes to gender, yeah, one of the things that's heavily discussed is toys. Yeah, this is a social construct. You know, if there was no interference, then girls would play with trucks and boys would play with dolls. So is there a link between gender and toy preferences? Yeah, let's have a look. Our first study shows, let alone human beings, yeah, there is also a gender difference in the toy choices of primates. Yeah, as you can see on the screen, there's a few studies there. Now, there's two studies now which show gender differences in infants before they can even reach an age for them to be socialized. So here we have a study that says the same thing but uses digit ratios and testosterone. Yeah, so testosterone can be measured in from the urine. And also, when I say digit ratios, for men you'll notice that your ring finger is longer than your index finger. So this is of course further strengthened by, there's something called CAH, yeah, which is when certain girls have a higher exposure to testosterone in the uterus. Yeah, so the study also considered them and noticed that they were more inclined towards masculine toys. So it does show that when you are in the uterus, testosterone does affect you, yeah, and your gender. Now, Sweden scores very high on gender equality and this whole LGBT kind of movement, and they did a study which concluded the same thing. You might think this is in the West, but another study was done by Jean-Pierre Rossi, yeah, in 2005. His study was done in Saharan and North African regions, which concluded the same thing. And if that's not all, Grossman says in his study in 2007 that even in ancient Greece, we see evidence of this as well. So when I was trawling through the internet looking for responses that were done towards Dave Chappelle, most of the people made it seem like the LGBT community is benign. Yeah, they're benign, like they don't have much support, a very small kind of minority. This group has government, yes, government backing. Yeah, you will see, as you see on the screen, it is done on a higher level. Yeah, they have educational backing through Ofsted. And then we move on to celebrities. Yeah, those that want to gain relevance again, that have maybe dried up or washed up, like Demi Lovato. Yeah, in sports, you see them wearing bands. The Olympics, of course, we know that there was a trans male that was participating in an all-females event. London Zoo, as you guys can see, and even scientific journals like Nature and CMAJ of Canada. And not to forget, BBC glamorizing this trans lifestyle to our nine-year-old children. And also they make it seem like, nah, we don't attack anybody, nah, people attack us all the time. Okay, let's have a look. DaBaby. Yeah, DaBaby actually had his events cancelled, yeah, because of his comments. JK Rowling, she says that she has received death threats. Yeah, you've got countries like Poland, their cities were threatened to lose millions if they didn't put certain laws forward for the LGBTQ. And of course, you see this other headline for Wales as well. Yeah, Wales was under pressure by this lobby also. Also, you've got president of Harvard, yeah, Lawrence Summers. When he mentioned a few things, he was pushed, literally pushed, and eventually he resigned. You've also got James Damore, who used to be senior software engineer of Google, mate. Hit of Google. My guy got fired.
Fired.
So these are just a few examples of how powerful this lobby actually is.
By the way, the first thing I always wonder is, why do you care?
All right, so what are the harms of this? Why am I wasting my time talking about this? If gender is non-binary, yeah, not male and female, there's, according to the BBC, hundreds of genders, then will it not harm the women that have worked hard to gain some sort of respect? Yeah, we have been plastered and banged on the head with the news of Afghani women. But according to these individuals, how do you know that they were women? Yeah, why are you talking about women's rights if we're talking about second and third wave feminism? Yeah, did anybody ask their pronouns? But there, no, don't need, they're women. They're women over there. And secondly, guys, there's one that's called moon gender, which only comes out at night. There's another one called arbor gender, which is you identifying as a tree. I mean, come on. If you're in a conversation with somebody and they suddenly decide that they're a plum tree now, I mean, how do you get on with your day-to-day life, mate? It just leads to absurdities. Number three, contradictions within the movement. You've got bisexual, yeah, which is you like men and you like female. You have trans, yeah, that have transitioned from male to female or female to male. So on the one hand, you're saying, okay, there is such thing as male, female, female, male. And then you've got gender fluid or gender non-binary. It says, no, there is no male and female, mate. There's like hundreds upon hundreds of genders. How do you reconcile all of these? Number four, the definitions are constantly changing, yeah? And the LGBTQ community are becoming more accepting. Like, even if you do something small, nope, you're part of our community, mate. Yeah, if a boy puts on the shoes of his mother, LGBT. If a little girl starts playing with boys' toys, yeah, you know, she might need to transition there. If there's a feminine gay men or masculine lesbians, they're labeled as non-binary when in reality, they're just gender non-conforming. Number five, there are clinics, yeah, in the UK, the most prominent clinic is Tavistock and Portman. And they are receiving kids as young as three that are being claimed as gender dysphoric. Yeah, how does a child who's three, they don't have the emotional intelligence. Yeah, you might argue with me. Okay, then why is it that a three-year-old can't vote or drive a car or drink alcohol here in the West? Because they're not seen as mature. Then why is it that if your child says at the age of three, I want a tattoo, you say no. But if they're a boy and they say, yeah, I'm a girl now. And you're like, oh, okay, I'll take that. This is, what on earth is going on here? And then they get puberty blockers and hormone therapy and it's ridiculous. And that leads me on to the next point, yeah? Trans regret. You've got so many people that then regret after doing these operations. Like Carabelle, she, at age 20, took a clinic to court because she chopped off her breasts. And she took them to court because she said she was under 18 and they weren't rigorous enough. They didn't, you know, pursue her parents. They didn't make sure everything was done properly. They just put her through fast track.
Why is it so important to you what someone does with their life? With their life.
Let me ask you a few questions. Can boys refuse to dress in front of girls who actually identify as boys? Or are you a transphobe? Can a Muslim woman, yeah, refuse to massage a man who's identifying as a woman? Yeah, I'm a woman, mate. No, you're not. Look at your beard. It's coming all the way to your chest now, but identify as a woman. You got to massage me now. What, she's going to be a transphobe now for not doing so? And can women be upset when men identifying as females beat them in competitions? Or are they transphobic too? Reflect on those, and I'm going to leave it there, guys. Don't forget to share this video, and until next time, Assalamu alaikum.